Gentleman from 13.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. To debate against the bill.
You have the floor.
Mr. Speaker, I don't know if the individuals, and I respect the good lady from District 19 that worked on this budget, but I was handed a graph that show over 42 individuals that work in higher ed that make more than $200,000 a year. We have students that are struggling to get into college. We have student debt that is continuing to spiral. We see rising costs in education. When I was there, one of my professors said to the class, he said, look, you better get out of here as quick as you can because they're going to continue to raise costs. We were seeing costs when I was in college, 2004, 5, 6, of 10% on an annualized basis. To see that you've got individuals that are, and I'm leaving the athletic folks out. I'm talking of provosts and deans and vice presidents, et cetera, making salaries over $200,000. I think we need to go back to the drawing board and we need to relook at this budget and we need to tell colleges and universities, we're not just gonna cut $500,000 here or there out of your budget. We're gonna get serious about cutting budgets. The other thing, Mr. Speaker, that really has my ire up is 28 of us sent a letter to the president of Boise State University talking to her about some concerns that we had with respect to the university. Upon receipt of that letter, she did meet with some of us and heard our concerns, but she went right out and hired a vice president of diversity. That was a direct affront to us, to me personally as a legislator. I have some concerns about that. Boise State has continued to operate for years without a vice president of diversity. And when we expressed our concerns, she did not heed our concerns. She went ahead and said, you know what, I'm gonna do what I wanna do and I'm gonna hire one anyways. And we are the legislative body. It's our job to set budgets and craft policy. And so with that, Mr. Speaker, I'd ask for your red light.